Maritime consultant and economist Cuthbert Didier says, although St. Lucia fared very well in containing the spread of the coronavirus, he thinks that the yachting sector should have been reopened since the 1st of June. St. Lucia's economy, he says, needs resuscitating, and the yachting sector, he says, plays a major part in doing so.
And the reason I'm saying that is all the islands went through a shutdown except St. Vincent and the Grenadines. So most of these yachts persons were actually quarantined on their yachts on various islands or on different water parts of the Caribbean. Having said that, the economy, St. Lucia's economy, has been comatose since then. We're slowly trying to get back to normal, but it's obvious that the economy needs oxygen. Oxygen meaning it needs people to be spending money for services. And one sector which continually has been spending significant amounts of money, and I know I've been saying this for almost three decades, yachtsmen and yachtswomen have been spending in the Caribbean a lot more than cruise ship.
The charter subsector of the yachting industry is where the real challenge lies. The new normal, he says, is that boats will need to be sanitized after every charter in a more intense manner than before. There is also the need for firm policies for quarantine, he says, and there are many options for doing so.
Are we going to put them on anchor, create almost like a bubble, have 40 moorings in the inner lagoon of Rodney Bay or 40 moorings in Marigot Bay or a specific location in Soufre? Or are we going to facilitate them through the quarantine structures or establishments that the government manages? Are we going to test them upon arrival? So I would think, and I would like to suggest, that what we do is understand the yachting sector first and then try to fit in the protocols that the Ministry of Health, led by the CMO, wants to see. Because the main important point here is you're not going to have that much community spread. The yachts people, most of the persons who are cruisers, for example, are above the age of 60. So they're in the vulnerable sector. So they're not going to be walking around and putting themselves at risk. These persons are going to be on the yacht. They're going to be to manage their health. A lot of them, you know, they buy their food, they eat on board, you know, and you can create an area where they can stay, policed by the Marine Police or St. Lucia ANC Port Authority or the Port Health Authorities.
In terms of opening up the borders and allowing yachts to move freely, Mr. DJ says that should be an OECS initiative. Three islands, however, have already started up with that trend. While St. Vincent and the Grenadines never closed it down, Antigua and Barbuda and Grenada are already on the go with the initiative. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Busquet.